to be doing another high rep squat set today. We're putting on the belt. We're going to get 363 for 10. This is another one I'm amped up to do. Probably going to run this phase a little bit longer. These all out high rep squat sets, alternating between some of the bars, belt and no belt. I'm going to do a beltless set of 25 on Monday, so stay tuned for that. Gotta get ready. We're gonna crush this one. This one's just, we're gonna obliterate it. Gotta get psyched though. Okay, I'm gonna get my belt on. Gonna go a little more water and get some chalk, and then we'll get to her. Sure, I got some shirt room with this belt so I can breathe. Like I said, I believe in kind of alternating during this phase, doing some sets with the belt and some sets without the belt. Obviously, this is the phase where I'm running one all-out set. I wouldn't recommend anybody run a program like that for probably more than 3 months. Straight, you probably burn off before that. I'm sure I'm probably gonna run it for another like 2 more weeks of doing like these all sets, if that. And then I'll return to something more base building, really a few reps in the tank, stuff like that. Because you don't always have to train for it. Keep that in mind. This is just a phase that I'm doing with squats. In fact, with deadlift and bench press, I never really go failure very often. So depends on the lift, depends on you, you know. So this is just a phase that I'm running with squats. There's nothing magical about doing, you know, all out sets to, you know, close to failure, so. myself exhilarated, people. Man, I was like, man. Because I can grip the bar way better. Alrighty, people. Oh. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can't go wrong. tell you, when you dial in, you put your mind to it, you can crush any goal. It's all up here. When you put your heart and soul into it, man,